What's up, everybody, and welcome back to my studio. I'm Joseph Finchum, you are you, and today we're going to work on this a little bit more. I don't know if you can tell, I did play with the settings a little bit, so I definitely got some of this purple showing, but some of this blue is still a little too purpley looking. I mean, this is blue and this is purple, but here it's just light purple and dark purple. And also, this is a little bit more of a reddish orange. So, I didn't have time to switch the cameras like I wanted to. So, it is what it is. So, I also screwed up a bunch of stuff in my studio because I got a new phone and trying to switch things over from my old phone to my new phone. I lost a bunch of my lights and stuff, so I can't control them anymore without having to actually touch stuff. Audio, video, check, check. Mic check, video check, all good. Yes, great. Hello, Nick. Hello, Angela. And hello, Tara. Thank you all for joining me. So, let's get into this. What do I need here? I need my water. George Pencil Art said, "Nice, yes, that blue is more blue now. Looks more accurate. Good job, Joseph. Thank you very much." So, hello, George, and hello, Sim Mac. Thank you for joining me. I'm trying out the new chat thing that Angela was using, and so far it is definitely easier to use Angela, but the one thing it doesn't have is the banner things that I was using that said, like, welcome to my, you know, channel, and what I was concentrating on today. Those little banners are gone, so I don't have those, but the chat is definitely easier to use. Okay, so, the first thing I know I want to do is I want to try and adjust. I'm painting from an angle over here, like facing this way, instead of facing this way, and so this is actually a little oblong, and I'd like to fix that. Clark Fine Art said, "Yeah, I love it and found a workaround for those two. I will send you more info." Thank you very much. But yeah, the being able to see everything and click on it easily, that's good. Okay, so definitely want to reshape this a little bit. And I may have to paint some white on there. Yeah, definitely going to need some white there. Probably end up needing a few coats. Let me grab a wiping towel because I'm gonna need some white. Hopefully that won't be too bad. And I really just need to cover up the green. So, it shouldn't be too bad if I get a little orange mixed in there. Gonna have to let that sit for a second. And I had to get a new phone because my phone carrier, who will remain nameless because they don't need any advertising from me. I mean, I do it. But yeah, they sent me an email the other day that was like, oh, by the way, in a couple of months your phone's gonna be garbage and you won't be able to use it anymore. So it was finally time to upgrade. It's not the greatest thing in the world, but it's better than the one I had. Try and soften this edge a bit so I don't have to worry about blending it out easy too much. This a little bit. I want to fix some of these spots in here. Try and get them to be the right shape. And these leaves need a little bit more shape to them because this is not the shape of a pumpkin leaf. And they still won't be the perfect shape of a pumpkin leaf, but hopefully they'll be a little bit better. I'm just working on adjusting the shapes, and I don't plan on finishing this today. I don't think I will. Am I still streaming? I think I am. Yep. Okay. Just making sure. Usually it's me who's quiet. Today it's you guys. Thanks, Nick. I have an idea for how I want to do, like, the moon, and I still don't know yet if it's going to work, so I might not even, I mean, I might block it in today, but I definitely won't finish that today because I'm going to have to experiment with the airbrush to see if I can even get what I want out of it done. I know that didn't make any sense to you guys because you can't read my thoughts. But we'll see what we get done. Right now, I'm just trying to darken up these shadows a bit. Build a little texture with some brush strokes. Trying to get some nice clean lines here. Cover up some of this little extra white overspray from when I airbrushed the moon and leaf shapes in the first time. But we'll be repairing all that as we go. Darker. We all have those moments, Tara. We definitely all have those moments. It'll come to you. Just give it some time. Yeah, sometimes you gotta add information to the title, yeah. Hi, Alicia. Thank you for stopping by for a while. I appreciate it. Back into some orange. Hopefully I got most of the green out of that. Because I'm not switching brushes just yet, and I don't want this going brown on me. I'm getting my big head in the way. Just making sure my angles are right. Probably should have covered that up a little bit more, but we'll see how it goes. white showing through than I want in some of these spots where I didn't get into the tooth, so I'm just trying to fix that. Trying to get the paint very thin so it flows right in, right down in there. Probably will come back with some white later to give it some highlights, but I'll want those where I want those and not just all over the place like they are now. Bit. Hi, Starving. Thank you for joining. Hi, Cats Art Pics. Thank you for joining. I appreciate you guys being here. It's a lot better than trying to do it by yourself. probably should. Some red or some magenta I should have out, but I don't. So eventually I'll have to grab that. Okay, we're getting there. I want this whole area to be a little bit more in shadow. I'm not happy with them yet, Starving, but they're better than they were. They have a little bit more of a pumpkin shape, pumpkin leaf shape to them now anyway, so. Actually got some paint on the brush. There we go. Yeah, and we all know that Starving definitely needs that time. Okay. What am I doing here? Okay. I gotta let some of that orange dry. So let's see if we can go back into some of the green. Maybe brighten up some parts of these. That's going to be a little too thin, I think. Is that coming through? Probably not at all. Ooh, yes. Yes, you can always add more layers. You cannot rip your skin off. Run out of green. What was I looking at? Phone is ringing. Well, vibrating. I'm sure it was nothing. Yes, you can sort of see the palette, Clark. I tried to do that on purpose. It's a glass picture frame I bought at Walmart. It was $3. That's it. I don't go for all them fancy palettes. Put the paint on it, and after I'm done, I let it dry, spritz it with some water, scrape it over the razor. Nice and easy. Mine should be Nick. Nick said my phone is for outgoing calls only. Mine definitely should be. And I don't know. I don't know if these shadows are coming out quite the way I want them. Seem to have lost the edge of this piece of vine, so I'm trying to adjust that. Better. See if I can get some paint right on the tip of this brush so I can get a nice clean edge over here. Say my hi, Shortney. Thank you for joining me. Thank you for the compliment. You're fancy. You like the palettes. I think my problem is less. Not wanting the it's not that I don't want the fancy palettes, it's more of, I used to have that stuff all the time when I was a kid. What was it called? Money. And I don't have any of that anymore. Shauna, that's a tough one for me to answer because I don't work. I mean, I take care of my house, I do yard work, I clean the house, I do stuff like that, but I don't have a full-time job outside of this, and this doesn't pay me either, so. How do I stay motivated? Watch Lisa's video that she just did on motivation, because it's not about motivation, it's about getting in there and doing it. Like that old, boring Nike slogan, just do it. Running out of green again, or it's drying too fast on me. I also don't like putting a lot of paint out because, as you can tell, I spread it too far around on my palette and usually lose most of it. And I hate wasting stuff. That's still too wet there. Orange should be dry by now, so give that another quick coat. Paint is just a little too, or this color is just a little too transparent. I don't know if you guys probably can't even see that. That's usually when I'm dismissed as well. When the cats have eaten. Thank you, Shortney. And it's a simple background too. It's just a couple of different colors and a couple of light stencil marks. Boom. And I will be adding some more stuff in it after I have more stuff done. There is, I don't know if I've actually described the whole thing, because like I said, it's all up here. I don't have reference or even a sketch. But there's going to be a full moon up here. There's going to be like the silhouette of a black, like dead kind of fall tree. On this side, with a couple branches coming out, maybe a couple bats, and then I do want to, I'm going to make some stencils, and I'll put a couple of little, like, ghosts coming out, flying around, couple of flying bats, the moon, what I was trying to say before was that the moon, I want to do something kind of specific, but I don't want to give it away yet. But it's going to be kind of a tealy, aquamarine, blue, green, teal. You follow Lisa, you know what teal is. It's going to be a teal color, and then I want to do that, like, that highlight thing that Lisa does all the time. And I don't know how that'll look, but it should be pretty. And I'm still trying to judge where the face of this jack-o'-lantern is going to actually go. And I'm going to need a thinner brush for that. Where are all my brushes? Decisions. Do I want it facing more forward or three-quarter view? Yeah, let's go for more forward. Okay, so your eyes are going to be... there. And then the other side will be, use that whole section there to adjust that shape. Yeah, this one's definitely a little taller. Fill this in a bit. And I will be building these shapes up in layers. What do we got here? Yes, Nick, I suck at efficient color mixing. Yes, that is the problem. Thank you for putting that into words for me. This is where it's going to be tough, because I know I can see in my head the kind of mouth I want. this working?
It looks like it's working. Hair on the brush. That ain't good. An unhappy little tree lives right there. Yep. That one is not a happy. That one is a happy accident. An unhappy accident. Brr. I can't speak today. Thank you, starving. Me either, Shortney. I don't know how to use mine either. I definitely don't practice as much as I should. that's why I'm kind of still relegating myself to,
you know, simple backgrounds until I'm, you know, at least somewhat better with it. This paint is a little too thick. Now it'll probably end up being a little too thick.
Okay.
We're definitely getting there. Okay, let me...
I've just come to realize that I don't actually know what color the vine is. I want to say greenish gray, but I don't know if that's right. it just jumped. I think that's the first time I've ever had a jump. You and a few other people. I'm trying to think of who the quote is by. The one that goes, "An artist can't fail. It is a success just to be one," or something like that. Why can't I think of it offhand? Yes, we learn from our mistakes. Yes, true, true. Not sure if this was directed at me, George, but if it was, this is acrylic, not oils. Thank you, Clark. I do kind of like his face as well. I'm trying to get caught up, so. Ooh, cat's hard picks. Only with alcohol? What is it? What's it made out of? Easy, clean palette, okay. Yeah. See, told you, I need to get caught up. Oh, Jack Skellington.
Yes. You could definitely say this is highly Jack Skellington and inspired. Definitely not be too much of a leap. Also, a tiny bit of the band Mushroom Head. If you've ever heard of them. Maybe even a little Evil Ernie, who was a comic book character. Some shadows. Not that I don't think you couldn't figure out what I was doing. Buy Cat's Art Pics. Took me too long to catch up, so I'm sorry if I missed your exit.
That's a good one, too. Nelson Mandela. Okay, where am I? I need this to go a little bit darker. Not thin enough. Might be a little too dark, but that's okay. Okay. Now we can start working on this face a little bit more. I need some more white. Uh-oh. Need a place to mix where I haven't put paint yet. And that's the problem with leaving your palette dirty, is you can't remember where you have wet paint and where you have old dry paint. I'm gonna go for right here. Trying to get that inside the pumpkin, the meat of the pumpkin color.
I'm just kind of trying to glaze it on. And you know, I have two pumpkins outside. I probably could have carved one into the shape of this jack-o'-lantern and used that as a reference. But definitely not going to finish it today, so I still have time to do that. Thank you, Starving. That's... yes. I started thinking maybe I was getting a little too detailed, too fast. But it's definitely working for me. It probably took me, I don't know, a couple of days. I kept going back and forth between, like, the alien kind of almond-shaped eyes. But it didn't really look right, because the teeth are so jagged, you know? It made it look more happy, if that makes sense. So, yeah, it went with the traditional jagged lines. Let's see if I can thin that just a little bit more. Just trying to make sure I covered all of the white in these spots that I'm doing. Making sure my sharp teeth are sharp. Because I'm still not exactly sure. I mean, I probably could just fill in that whole area. But I'm not sure exactly how I want it to look in the end. Maybe just fill some of them in. Whoops. That was a mistake. Because I know I'm trying to save some of the white, because I don't want to make it too dark, because there's going to be a very dark ridge around the top and the bottom,
and then highlights right, you know, right on that. Because you know how pumpkins, they get that, you know, they shrink in on themselves a little bit right at all the edges. And I want to get that highlight in there at some point. The mixing real estate is getting slim. Indeed. Well, my answer for that one, Clark, is, you know, do I even have it out here? No, I think it's in my travel case at the moment. But the one that's got the three different sections in it, but I only ever use one of them. But it's so far it's been my favorite pencil sharpener ever. Definitely better than the electric ones I've ever had. They either die, or if the batteries start getting low and you don't notice it, and it's kind of like, it doesn't have a smooth turn when the battery's low, and it just, you know, rip, it chunks away at the wood. But I like myself a nice little handheld metal one. Indeed, that's a good idea. I have, it's not visible. On the windowsill there, I have a manual cranking one, and it's never been quite sturdy, even though it's bolted to my windowsill, and it drives me nuts. I'm sure it's just an old, cheap one, and that's the problem. Helix A5. I can read.
See if we can. Oh yeah, I'm starting to get to that point where I've made the paint below the paint that I'm mixing too soft. I may end up getting chunks of paint in my paint, and I don't want that. Mix up some more in that spot. Want it to be slightly darker than what I already put down. And a little more opaque. Think of how the shape will be.
Yeah, even if I go to full screen, I don't think that'll show up. Maybe I can... Let's see if this is a bad idea. That's not a terrible idea, moving that. Trying to keep in mind the three-dimensional shape of what the slices into the pumpkin would look like in the back, if that makes sense to everybody. And I'm not sure I'm making it dark enough for you guys to actually be able to see what I'm talking about, so... A little thicker than that. Thank you.
That's starting to get there.
Right there with you, Tara. And the old metal one. Yeah. Old metal handhelds are the... They do the best. I have two Coom ones. And I don't know what the name of the 3-1 is. I got it with something else. And it's been my favorite pencil sharpener yet. Darker in there. I don't think I'm going to try and make it look like it's glowing, but I may at some point if I think it'll work. But who knows? What am I doing here? I think I still have a little bit of this left because I completely forgot to do these guys. Pretty sure I don't want to continue to completely fuss with this too much while it's all still a little wet. I don't want to create mud. yeah, we definitely got some more done. And I'm going to do an old-fashioned quick blocking in of the moon. That too big? Too small? Well, I can always adjust it to be a little bit bigger if I want to, but we're going to start with this. And some straight white with a big fat brush. Because we're just blocking it in. That'll do. So, yeah, that's pretty much where we're gonna leave it. I know, it doesn't look like I got all that much done. It was because it was mostly shading and correcting things I did wrong last time. So. And I just saw that after I forgot to zoom out. So, yeah. There's always one problem, isn't there, Clark? You always gotta forget something. And I'm still gonna continue to try and futz over these colors. Because I don't know if it'll work just like I did the last time. But I'll show it to the other camera and we'll see if that helps at all. And I just threw my paper towels away, so I need a new one. Good for now, until I get a chance to clean them in 10 minutes. Let's see here. So, left, right, up, down. How's that look? We're getting there. See if I can get some more light on it. Left, down, up, right. I can never figure this out. But yeah, we're getting there. I'm definitely going to think about switching these cameras. Because who knew that the old junky camera, the no-frills cheap camera, was going to have the better color. So. And if I move them, is that going to mess everything up? And it'll switch. Who knows? So yeah, so that's where I'm calling it. Check me out on the socials. Hit the buttons, do the things. Check out Nick and Angela's channels. Links are always in the description, and Lisa's channel. Wouldn't do this without Lisa's pushing me. I just put up a new challenge video. I just put up a new where was I for a month video. Some people have found some humor in that. Turtle yoga. And yeah, check out the new challenge, which is up in the MeWe and Facebook groups. It's Halloween inspired. So anything Halloweenish, spooky, creepy, horror, no gore, But yeah, stuff like that. And yes, it does. It looks, this camera here is just washing everything out, and I don't know why. I still haven't been able to figure out why, but at least there's some purple this time. Last time it was all purple or all blue. This is a little bit more purple blue. So, I don't know. So yeah, thank you for joining me. Thank you for watching. And I'll see you next time. Bye.